绝对硬核，深度学术，非常烧脑，特别有趣。NECPA 北美华人电力协会专业报告。
COVID-19 has caused a havoc to our lives and to our society. We may wonder how the power industry that we care about and work for is doing and what will happen to it. Here are some info and thoughts that I would like to share with you all. Under the extreme condition caused by COVID-19, most power grid operators, such as ISO RTOs, have taken extreme cautions to limit access to the control rooms and to isolate control room operators from other people. Some have sequestered operators, that is, have the volunteered operators stay at the site or next to the control room 24/7. Some control centers have camping trailers wheeled in to provide the living quarters for the operators and for them to be physically isolated. The operators have been tested for coronavirus. Those who are not sequestered have taken self-quarantine at home to be ready for reinforcement. Under COVID-19, generators have been sharing information on fuel access, supply chain, and are providing each other backups for plant operators, maintenance crews, etc., although there are competitors in the marketplace under normal conditions. Most generators deferred non-essential maintenances to later this year in the wake of COVID-19 safety measures. Similarly, transmission owners have been implementing their business continuity plan, geared up measures in operators' safety, real-time operation, and coordination to ensure transmission availability. Transmission and distribution maintenance work has been delayed because of the COVID-19 restrictions on workforce. Except for emergency or to respond to customer calls to keep the lights on. For the health and integrity of their field crews, many utilities are adopting new practices, like not allowing two people in one truck or in one bucket in the field work. Regarding the impact on utilities, the deferring maintenance now may become a bill that will come due this summer. Many utilities may have issues on transmission and distribution circuit because most facilities are designed for summer or winter peak days with sufficient maintenance work done before the peak load seasons. For example, distribution feeder system serving residential area during the hottest days of the summer or during storms would require a good condition and margins on the facilities. Without maintenance and services done, the utilities would need to evaluate risks and find possible solutions such as emergency operation plans to prepare or to repair. All the good work done so far on resilience, reliability, better automation, and situational awareness will definitely help in this case. However, the reality is that automation and sensors won't prevent damage. Demand-side management may prevent overload-related damage, but not storm damage, for example. Demand-side management, if used too often, may have fatigue issues and become ineffective. If COVID-19 prolongs for a few months, this situation may be exacerbated with the weather-related events such as storms, hurricane, hot summer days later. Some forecasters have said that it will be a long and hot summer this year. The utilities and the operation staff are always prepared for a few randomly scattered problems during any extreme summer, winter, or natural disasters, and they can handle that or with the help from other utilities. What they could be in trouble is a combination of many facilities reach peak simultaneously to the extent it causes concerns, and much longer peak durations or widespread major disasters. Now and later this year, more than ever, keeping the lights on is paramount and challenging. Demand has dropped off by 5 to 10% globally, as well as in the United States, for the past several weeks, compared to last month or last year, same time. There are many articles and publications on this already. Additionally, the load patterns are significantly changing in shape and demand mix, with industrial commercial loads decreasing and the residential loads increasing due to work from home or COVID-19 lockdown. The consumption pattern has changed as there is not much difference between weekday and weekend, day and night. Everyone is practicing his or her individual schedules at large. Lower peak and energy demand will affect utilities' capacity budget next year and in the future. Hopefully, the shelter-in-place order will soon be reinstated, and people will slowly dribble back to the workplace. Notwithstanding to the contrary, many may likely use an abundance of caution as an excuse by continuing to work from home for several months, several weeks, keeping the demand level flat, daily load curve skewed, which could be a new challenge for generation dispatch. Electric consumption is often highly correlated with indicators of employment and overall economic activities. The short-term reduction of electricity demand happened as a result of the lockdown due to the COVID-19. But if the trend and the people's behavior continue, utilities would have to readjust the load forecast and plan the future new grid with reduced system peak and much different electricity consumption patterns. As of now, most of us have a genuine concern of the economy and on the path for recovery.